Dave, you have been with QPR for more than 15 years. How did it all start?
Well, it started when I was playing schoolboy football. I used to play football, same as most boys did at school at the time. And when I was playing for London schoolboys, one of the QPR scouts happened to be watching the game. And he asked me if I'd like to go down and train with the schoolboys in the evenings. And I've gradually over the years progressed through the junior teams, into the reserve teams and into the first team, and things have progressed from there on.
Looking back, Dave, would you say that a boyish dream has come through?
Oh yes, yes, I've had a wonderful 15 years so far, and I hope I've got a few more years to come.
How do you like to be an idol here in London?
Well, it's very nice to be recognised, although obviously, it brings certain amounts of pressures. You may be out in a restaurant and get recognised, and sometimes it is nice to just get away from football and relax with your family or friends without being recognised. But there again, it is nice all the same.
You are well paid, but you have to work for the money in Britain.
Yes, we work. We work hard, physically, very hard. Obviously, when you're playing big games, very important games, there's a lot of mental pressure as well. Our hours are sort of concentrated. We probably only work about two and a half hours a day. But it's very hard, concentrated effort. And, I mean, there's no way you could train any longer than that a day anyway, else you'd just be too tired to play on a Saturday. And I don't think we get paid any more than we deserve, really.
Lovely, great. Another one. Six, seven, eight. Come on.
Do you think players in the first division are too well paid in Britain?
No, in fact, the top players in Britain, I would say, are definitely the worst paid players in the world compared to, and I mean compared to players who, say, play for Italian clubs, German clubs, I mean even top French clubs now, pay far bigger salaries than the top clubs in England do. But these clubs in Italy, Germany, etc., are helped by sponsorship, and as yet we don't allow sponsorship in our country. And I think sponsorship will have to come in a big way in our country in order to pay better wages to players, else you're going to find that players are gradually going to go abroad for better wages, as Kevin Keegan has done, by going to Germany.
How is the relationship in QPR between you, between the players, the board, the coach and the manager?
Well, to be successful in football or any business, in fact, you've got to have you've all got to work as one, the manager, the coach and the players, if you want success. And at QPR, we do work as a nice team. You obviously do get pressures when you're not playing well or when you're losing, and sometimes things can become strained, but on the whole at QPR, we do work well together, everybody. And When things aren't going well, that increases the pressures on you.
How are the working conditions in QPR?
The conditions at QPR are very good. They're much better than they were a few years ago when we were a third division club. We didn't have much money. We had a bit of a run-down stadium. But over the last 8 years, we've put two new stands up. We've got new dressing rooms. We've got a lovely training ground. And things have improved immensely since I first started there.
Nine!
Run. Yeah. Hold it.
Get it.
Right. Right. Right.
Right.
Right.
Right. Right. You've got to watch your diet, though. You've got to get plenty of carbohydrates down.
To be a very good first division player, do you have to be a selfish player, Dave?
No, I don't think so. I've never been that sort of player. I mean, being a defender, you've got to be the type of player who works on his game, really. I'm not in a position to really be that type of player. Maybe forwards, successful forwards, I think you want them to be a little bit selfish so that they get the ball and they take on players and they score good individual goals. But as a defender, you can't really afford to be selfish.
How do you prepare for a vital game?
For a vital game?
Or a game?
Yes, we prepare the same way for really all matches. After the game on a Saturday, we have Sunday off, and we start training on the Monday in preparation for the game on a Saturday. We prepare in on a Monday. We usually have quite a hard day, the same on a Tuesday and a Wednesday, and gradually we start doing a little bit less so that we reach our peak for a Saturday. And we work on various things such as just pure physical fitness, but at our club we do a lot of ball work. We work a lot with the balls, and we work on free kicks. We may work on how the opposition may play against us, and know that Saturday obviously is the end product of the week's work. Well, as you know, we kick off at 3 o'clock on a Saturday, and you start to feel the pressure of a game probably about an hour and a half, 2 hours before the kickoff, when the supporters start to arrive and the stadium starts to fill, and you start to think about the game itself. You start to think about the opposition, the particular player you may be playing against, and various things start to run through your mind an hour and a half before kickoff, and all these little things will build up and reach a climax by 3 o'clock.
After the game, what's the reaction? I mean, if you have had a good game or a bad game?
We usually find in football that you reach very, very high peaks. You get very elated when you have a good win. And there again, when you lose, you find a depression sets in, and the players will have their heads down in the dressing room, be very, very quiet. Or they may in fact be arguing after the game because it could have been very important. Players lose money. They don't get any bonuses when they don't win. But there again, as I said, that when you do win, you get very, very elated, and you know, that's the sort of pressures I like. It's nice to be happy after the game, obviously, because you can go up to the bar and you know you're in a lot happier mood, and you're a lot happier when you come home to the wife.
Family must always come first. The wife's very understanding when I have to go away. Sometimes I'm away from home 2 or 3 weeks at a time, and sometimes it is a little bit hard on the wife and the block all. But so when I am home, I try to spend as much time with the family as possible.
Pat, do you find your situation different from the neighbours?
Since we've moved out to this new house, we live near the other players, so their wives are in the same position, so we see each other, and we've just started to play badminton together, so that's good. So it's not too bad, as long as you've got good friends.
Paul?
Huh?
Which player is your favourite player?
I just need him.
Are you supporting Chelsea? Your father used to support Chelsea. Which team?
QPR.
QPR. Are you watching Rangers playing at home? So David Needham is your favorite player. What about your dad? Is he not a good player? Would you like to move from this area if, for instance, Dave should be transferred to Sheffield or Manchester or Liverpool?
Well, I've always said to David that if a transfer came up and he couldn't get in touch with me, not to worry, just to go straight ahead. I'd always go wherever he had to go with his job.
Yeah, steady. Good one. Okay. Oh, that's minus 10. That's in the sand.
Yeah, that's a good goal. Yeah, come on, what a good shot. Bye.
Oh, good one. Is he finished? He hasn't finished, has he? Best take Gillies' place, then. Best take Gillies' place. Is he at that?
Well, really, most of my friends don't really talk that much about football, and it's nice, really, to be able to go out in the evening and not have to take your job with you, to be able to relax with friends who don't keep continually bringing up football all the time, and this is what usually happens when I go out. We don't really talk about football at all.
Bill? Oh, I'm spilling it. Okay. Ian, do you want another one? Ian. Lager? Here's your one. Oh no, I don't mean on film. I mean just because we can't move from the table. We're gonna.
Well, I represent the players. I advise all the young boys to go to and further their education, and if there's any problems between the players and management, I represent the players if there are any problems.
Well, you probably saw from your last wage slip, I'll give you the bad news first, that your union fees have been taken out of your wages, £3.25 for the year. So as soon as I get the membership cards through, I'll give them to you. And, you know, you'll have a certain number, which you'll keep throughout your career. Now, I'm always continually sort of mentioning to players about going to school, because I know at the moment all you do is think about football, don't you? Duck. And I know, you know, first and foremost in your mind, you want to be a first division footballer, but also you've got to be prepared for the worst. And, you know, things can happen. You can get a bad injury early in your career, and it's best to be safe and continue your education, because even if you haven't got a certain career in mind, it keeps your mind active, and it, you know, it won't do you any harm at all.
Okay.
Oh yes, well you can take your preliminary coaching badge, and
what about the football here in England in the future?
In the future, I think the lower divisions, the third and the fourth division, will definitely go part time. And what I mean by that is that I think players will train in the evenings and have another occupation during the day and play in a normal way on a Saturday, because the third and fourth division clubs can't really afford to pay players full-time anymore. They're getting bad gates. And it will be, in fact, in the players' best interest to go part-time, because they don't particularly earn very good money playing in the third and fourth division. And by having two jobs, it would be in their best interest. And I think in the top division, especially the first, in the big clubs, they will import foreign players, and I think you're going to get a drift of players playing for continental clubs from England, in Italy, Germany. There's going to be a big movement of players throughout Europe, I think.
What do you think you are going to do after the playing days are over?
Well, I hope I've got a few years to go. I've been on quite a few business courses and I'm quite interested in catering. I would like to go in, I would obviously like to stay in football, but there's lots of good managers in the game who can't in fact get jobs at the moment, or who've been in the game who can't get jobs at the moment. There's a lot of players who would like to stay on and there's not enough jobs to go around. So I'm preparing for the future by, I've been on business courses and on catering courses, and I'd like to go into something like a wine bar restaurant or a sandwich bar or maybe a pub when I finish football.